Rizzi's artwork seems to be in touch with the childlike fascination and wonder we all feel whenever we take the time to have a fresh look at the bizarre yet everyday parade of people, buildings, colors, sights, and smells, all packed elbow to elbow in the strange city of New York. And just as children constantly develop, learn, and grow throughout their years, Rizzi's bright and youthful artwork has never stopped in its development. These images you see now are infinitely more refined and cohesive than even those of only a few years earlier. The continual evolution of style and vision in James's work is as much one of his trademarks as his widely recognized cityscapes. Rizzi's prints, like the city itself, are a festival, boldly celebrating the sights of daily life. Ever grasp New York's bustling, sleepless energy so well before? And how does James Rizzi manage to capture the world he sees with such accuracy and candor?
I never pull out a pen and copy things. I try to keep things in my memory so that when I sit down to draw, I have to imagine it. And I think it always comes out better if I draw from memory or from my imagination of what I perceive something to look like rather than exactly what it does look like.
Rizzi's complex construction process makes it difficult to produce large quantities of works, and as they are handcrafted, no two constructions are identical. Rizzi's fastidious attention to detail is evident here as he examines the quality of each print in the stack. James Rizzi's enormous success in the nations of Europe and the Far East, as well as in the galleries of the U.S., is partly due to the support of his longtime friend, art dealer John Zilke.
In conjunction with the change in the economics, there's also a change in as to what the taste levels are and what the tastes are. And I notice now that there's a greater demand now for art objects and art-related objects. Which is natural for Rizzi because he's always doing things which are constructions, which are three-dimensional. Keith Haring was instrumental in starting those things, and Jimmy is now doing working on sculptures, vases. He's working on pins. He's working on telephone cards, which are very big in Europe and Japan. He even had done a limited edition silk necktie, and we hope to